Hello everyone, welcome back to the Sahyadri Tech channel. So in the previous session we have discussed about origin of electrode potential, how potential develops actually, and when considered oxidation electrode potential, reduction electrode potential, and relation between these for any half cell, and even defined the half cell and some important points to be remembered. Well, so before going for the today's session, just I'll recall the definition of electrochemistry once again. So what it is a branch of chemistry. It deals with the interconversion of two energy forms, we said, that is electrical energy and chemical energy. Means, so basically this chapter deals with the study of interconversion of electrical energy into chemical energy and vice versa. So we already come across a type of cell, or I can say device, that is electrolytic cell. Well, what is that electrolytic cell? It is a kind of device in which what happens? Electrical energy is converted into chemical energy. So I repeat, electrolytic cell, a device in which electrical energy is converted into chemical energy. So it is called electrolytic cell, we already mentioned, okay? And even we also considered the components of electrolytic cell, and even after that we studied about laws of electrolysis and etc. Well, here one type of reactions we already come across, or I can say one form of conversion, that is conversion of electrical energy into chemical energy. So it is done in by using electrolytic cell. So in electrolytic cell, what happens? Electrical energy used for chemical purpose, or overall electrical energies get converted into chemical energy. Well, what is the second one then? Reverse conversion. It means conversion of a chemical energy into electrical energy. So, or I can say, and even we mentioned, the basis for these interconversions are the spontaneous redox reactions. So, with the help of spontaneous redox reaction, as I explained, a redox reaction involves movement of electrons. That movement of electron is the basis for generation of a electrical energy. Therefore, it is possible to convert a chemical energy into electrical energy. It is done with a type of cells or devices called voltaic cell, or it is also called galvanic cells. Means it is the second type of cells. First one, electrolytic cell, in which what you have done? A electrical energy is converted into chemical energy. Now, today in this session, we are dealing with the voltaic cells, or they are also called galvanic cells. So in this cell, what happens? A device in which electrical energy is produced. Means we are going to generate electrical energy. How it is possible? Electrical energy is produced using a spontaneous chemical reaction. What type of reaction we are taking? A spontaneous chemical reaction involving oxidation and reduction. It means with the help of spontaneous redox reactions, we are going to generate electricity. Where? In a voltaic cell, or it is also called galvanic cell. Another way of defining the device in which, simply what I can say, chemical energy is converted into electrical energy. So, voltaic cells or galvanic cells are nothing but these are the devices in which a chemical energy is converted into electrical energy. So, it is called voltaic cell, or they are also called galvanic cells. Well, typical examples or well-known examples for these voltaic or galvanic cells are Daniell cell, nickel cadmium cell, etc. Okay, so I repeat the definition. What is voltaic cell? The device in which electrical energy is produced using a spontaneous reaction, spontaneous chemical reaction involving oxidation and reduction. Or else I can say the device in which chemical energy is converted into electrical energy. Simply, what we can say, these are the devices in which chemical energy is converted into electrical energy is called Voltaic cells, or they are also called galvanic cells. So what is the device? That is Voltaic or galvanic cell. And well-known examples are Daniell cell and nickel cadmium cell. Now, what are the requirements? Well, I wish to construct a galvanic cell. Voltaic cell means the basic things, the basic requirements of a galvanic cell are that galvanic cell consists of two half cells. We already know this. Half cell meaning a metal is in contact with the solution of its own ions is called half cell, single cell, and it is also called single electrode. So to construct a galvanic cell or voltaic cell, what is needed? We need two half cells. Again, we have types in a half cell, that is oxidation half cell and reduction half cell. Whether I need two oxidation half cell or two reduction half cell? No. Necessary thing is we need one oxidation half cell and one reduction half cell. Means the typical requirements to construct a galvanic cell is two half cells are necessary. Two half cells, that is one is oxidation half cell is needed, another one is reduction half cell is needed. We know the meaning of these well, oxidation half cell and reduction half cell. Further, both the half cells are externally connected by voltmeter, means we need a switch and voltmeter and connecting wires. Other requirements, if I consider both the half cells, we have a two half cells, say two vessel, in one vessel metal in which say it is oxidation, A is a oxidation half cell, another cell B, it is a reduction half cell. It contains metal plates. These metal plates are externally connected to voltmeter, so we need a voltmeter. Further, and the solutions of both the half cells are connected by salt bridge. Means, so just you imagine, say there will be two half cells, it means metal plates are immersed in their respective solutions, salt solutions. Say metals, those metal plates are externally connected to voltmeter with the help of switch. And whatever the solutions of the half cells are connected by salt bridge. So basic requirements to construct a galvanic cell, we need two half cells, one oxidation half cell, another one is reduction half cell, and both the half cells are externally connected by voltmeter and the solutions are connected by salt bridge. So these are the requirements of a galvanic cell. Well, coming to the some points to be remembered here is, we already mentioned in an electrochemical cell, what I mentioned, that is whenever I mentioned, gone through the illustration part, okay, during dealing with the origin of electrode potential, we come across two illustrations, that is zinc is placed in zinc sulfate solution, another one, copper is immersed in a copper sulfate solution. There what we observed, zinc plate is negatively charged. What is the reason I quoted? Since during oxidation what happens, whatever the metal ions form, they go to solution, but electrons remain on the metal surface. So that zinc plate is negatively charged. On the other hand, when copper is immersed in a copper sulfate solution, what I mentioned, that copper plate is positively charged, means all the copper ions will be get deposited on the surface, so first layer will be positively charged, that concept. So here anode oxidation, so anode is the electrode where oxidation takes place. It may be electrolytic cell or galvanic cell. Remember, it may be electrolytic or galvanic cell, or I can say voltaic cell. anode is electrode where oxidation takes place in both the case. But is negatively charged. In electrochemical cell, that anode is negatively charged. But in electrolytic cell, anode is positively charged. Now here, that negative charge, what I am saying, that negative charge due to accumulation of electrons on the metal surface. During oxidation, what happens? Electrons remain on the metal surface. Therefore, we say anode is negatively charged. Well, what about cathode? Cathode is an electrode where reduction takes place. So both case same, that is in electrolytic cell as well as electrochemical cell, that is Voltaic cell or against galvanic cell. At cathode, what happens? Always reduction takes place. But in this case, cathode is positively charged. Cathode is positively charged. Why we are specifying positive charge means here that positive charge is due to accumulation of cations of a solution. Whatever the solution, cations present in the solution, they get deposited on the metal surface. So that electrode becomes positively charged. This is the basic thing. So these are the two points to be remembered with respect to Voltaic cell or against galvanic cell, or else generally called electrochemical cell. Then I said to construct a typical galvanic cell, what is needed? Two electrodes needed, two half cells are needed, oxidation half cells, reduction half cells, and both are externally connected to voltmeter, and solutions are connected by salt bridge. As we mentioned, the solutions of both the half cells are connected by salt bridge. Well, what is the salt bridge? Salt bridge is an inverted U-shaped glass tube. Salt bridge is nothing but what it is? It is the inverted U-shaped glass tube filled with gelatin gel saturated with either potassium chloride, potassium nitrate or ammonium nitrate. So what is salt bridge? It is a glass tube. What is the shape of that glass tube? It is a inverted U-shaped tube. It is a U-shaped tube which is placed in an inverted fashion. So we call a inverted U-shaped glass tube filled with either gelatin gel or alumina gel, okay, or agar-agar. It is saturated with what type of electrolyte? Potassium chloride or potassium nitrate or ammonium nitrate. So first look at the definition for salt bridge. So what is salt bridge? It is a inverted U-shaped glass tube filled with gelatin gel saturated with KCl or KNO3 or NH4NO3. Okay, it is called salt bridge. I hope you got the definition. Now coming to the electrolyte. Well, KCl, KNO3, ammonium nitrate. I specified three electrolytes. Either KCl, it is saturated with either potassium chloride, potassium nitrate or ammonium nitrate. Well, why not other electrolytes? There may be a question, right? Why we are not using other electrodes? Why only these specified electrolytes? Means here these ions of a salt bridge, that is here K plus Cl minus, K plus NO3 minus, ammonium nitrate, that is NH4 plus and NO3 minus. Whatever the ions of a electrolyte, they have equal mobility. Their mobility is almost equal, same. So both move with a speed of say 20 kilometer per second. It means, just I am mentioning, generally what we have to say here, the mobility of these ions are almost same. They move with a equal speed. Therefore, such electrolytes are used here. So what are the electrolytes found? KCl, KNO3, NH4NO3. Therefore, salt bridge is saturated with these electrolytes. Well, what is the significance? The significance of salt bridge. First significance, it prevents the intermixing of solution of two half cells. So there will be two half cells, those solutions are kept separately, therefore the intermixing of both the solutions can be avoided with by using salt bridge. Okay, well, if both the solutions are mixed, what happens? It not act as a galvanic cell, rather it act as electrolytic cell. It's a simple answer. Means instead of taking separately, if you take both the solutions in a single container, what happens? It simply act as a electrolytic cell, but not as galvanic cell or voltaic cell. Therefore, it is necessary to take two half cells separately. But to complete the circuit, what is needed? We need a salt bridge. So first significance, it prevents the intermixing of solution of two half cells. If both the solution mixes, what happens? It acts as a electrolytic cell. So just to avoid that, we are using salt bridge. So it is the first significance. Second significance, for the flow of electricity, two necessary conditions. First, there must be a potential difference, and second thing, there must be a complete circuit. So the circuit is get completed by using salt bridge. So it completes the circuit. So it is the second significance. Third significance, it prevents the liquid junction potential, and fourth one, it maintains electrical neutrality in both the half cells. Means during oxidation, that is in oxidation half cell, what happens? Electrons remains on the metal surface, cations goes to solution. Okay, just analyze. Say in oxidation half cell, the solution contains say 100 cations and 100 anions. Solution is neutral. But during reaction, what happens? Say 10 cations goes to solution. Now what happened? 110 cations, only 100 anions. Now what happened? Electrical neutrality will be disturbed. Now solution becomes electrically positively charged. In that moment, what happens? Salt bridge is going to supply anions. Salt bridge is going to supply anions to the oxidation half cell, so that the solution again maintains the electrical neutrality. Similarly, on the other hand, in reduction half cell, reduction takes place. Means cations of a solution go on depositing on the metal surface. Say out of 100 cations, 10 is get deposited. What is the remaining ions? 90 cations and 100 anions remain in a solution. In reduction half cell, say if 10 cations get deposited, 90 cations remains in a solution, but 100 anions remains in a solution. Again, solution is going to face electrical neutrality. In such case, again what happens? Salt bridge is going to supply its cation. Salt bridge is going to supply its cation to the reduction half cell, so that overall what we are saying, it maintains the electrical neutrality in both the half cells by supplying anion to the oxidation half cell, cation to the reduction half cell. Okay, is it clear regarding salt bridge and its significance? Again, in the next session, we discuss about some other concept of electrochemistry. Thank you.